judge of everyone, and ni hao, namaste, sabai ni. That's as much as I know in the various language, and if I miss your native tongue, I would like to learn. I would like to learn more. So welcome to your state capital. I've been encouraged by Ms. Seher to tell a little bit about my Asian American story, my Asian American experience. And you know, there's a lot of challenges that are unique to us as Asian American, but I know that today we're gonna spend most time talking about that, and I don't wanna go too much in detail on the issue. But I thought I'd share with you the first impression about that I have about America when my family first arrived here in Sioux Falls, South Dakota in the late 1970s. You know, it was cold, just like here now, and you know, but one thing that our host sponsor, which is the Zion Lutheran Church, want to make us feel at home, being that we're from a tropical country. Our food ingredients is different, so Sioux Falls, South Dakota at that time don't have any Asian shop at all. So the congregation of the Zion Lutheran Church make sure that almost every Sunday they will make announcement to the congregation, say that if anyone travel from Sioux Falls to Minneapolis, make sure you find a bottle of soy sauce to bring back to the Hurd family. So even though that was 40 some years ago, I still take that to heart. And the Zion Lutheran Church may have forgotten that they have helped us in that way. I still take that to heart in welcoming our newest American, whether it's Bhutani, Korean, you know, or even refugee and immigrant from East Africa. You know, and all newcomers to our state, to our country. So that's the philosophy that I live on, and I also carry on as a legislator of Minnesota. Another thing I want to share with you about, she also wanted me to share with you about my experience as an Asian American in the Minnesota legislature. You know, I find it very rewarding, and I also see that my community or my Asian community see it as a very rewarding as well, having someone who understands them, who shares similar culture with them, to be serving as state senate. So, you know, but I'm also thankful that we have the council here, and not just the Asian council, but you know, other ethnic council, the Latino council, and the African American Heritage Council. And also the Indigenous Council as well, to provide us some support. They're the extra ears and eyes for us in case we are missing some point, and they also stand by us on a number of issues. And, you know, I'm glad that while I'm here, I have been working with the Asian Council on gender-based violence and prevention, and so I'm gonna continue to be a champion on Asian issue for our state. So I'm glad that everybody's here, and that's the 2 points of my Asian American experience that I have shared with you today. So I'd like to get to know more of you, and do come by my office, or I'm gonna be here with you all throughout the program and still socialize with you. I, you know, met a number of you before, and some of you are new faces to me, and I wanna hear from you more. So thank you, and enjoy the rest of the day.